The National Environment Management Authority has been under pressure from both Kwale County government and environmental groups over the controversial licensing of sand harvesting in the Indian Ocean at the south coast. However, the authority insists due process was followed before the license was issued. The controversial license, which was issued to China Road and Bridge Corporation on the 22nd of May this year, was to allow the harvesting of 8,000 metric tons of sand offshore along the Indian Ocean from Likoni through Wa to Tiwi area in Kwale. The exercise has raised eyebrows as 30,000 households who are mainly fishermen face the risk of being affected by the dredging exercise, since their livelihoods depends on the sea, which is now under threat.
Wavuvi wote hawa ambao unawaona hapa, sio afya zao hizi. Wanakosa afya kwa sababu mtu anaenda kwa uvuvi, akitoka anatoka na samaki mmoja na ni mtu ako na family.
Also concerned are hotel stakeholders who argue that sediments dumped into the ocean during the dredging are likely to be washed back to the south coast beach by ocean currents, which will inevitably downgrade the award-winning status of Diani Beach, leading to further decline in the tourism industry.
Haitachukua muda sana ikiwa tutakubali hii mchanga iondolewe, itakuwa beach zetu hazitakuwa na mchanga tena na watalii hawatokuja tena hapo Diani.
If dredging is permitted to go on, it means the diving site, which has been a very big attraction for the underwater world, will be an end to that.
Kwale County Governor Salim Mvurya is also opposed to sand harvesting in the sea off Diani Beach, saying the practice is hampering conservation efforts.
The sand and the beach line is also a very good habitat for turtles. And therefore, any kind of activity that weakens or promotes erosion interferes with the habitat at that level. So we are not supporting dredging of sand at the beach.
World Wildlife Fund for Nature Kwale Project Executive Officer Elias Kimaru claims the contested license was issued following a shoddily done assessment.
As far as the current EIA and the studies are concerned, we are contesting that the license, NEMA should not have issued the license before a full study was done.
According to him, the dredging risks destroying the coral reef that offers a protective barrier from strong ocean currents. NEMA Kwale County Director George Peters has, however, come to the defense of the license in question that he says was duly issued.
As an authority, we also base our decisions on the advice that were given by relevant government agencies. And for the operations of the siphoning, the KMA, Kenya Maritime Authority, was properly consulted and they gave the project a clean bill of health.
Peter says they have halted the dredging exercise pending the determination of a petition presented to NEMA Tribunal by various environmental groups. The order from the National Environmental Tribunal to halt the dredging exercise deals a blow to the China Road and Bridge Corporation and is likely to affect its timetable for the development of the container terminal. Reporting from Kwale County, I am Anne Mburu.